Call to order. Special Community Development Committee. Time is 5:12 PM.
Alderman Moiseo. Alderman Seager.
Aye, here.
Alderman Florian. Alderman Kirkwood.
Here.
Alderman Turner.
Present.
Motion to approve the minutes of regular Community Development Committee meeting, June 3rd, 2019.
Motion.
Motion.
Motion by Alderman Turner. Second by Alderman Kirkwood. Any questions on motion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carried. Audience time, any questions? Any questions on the agenda? No old business. New business. Item A, resolution authorizing the sale of 100 South Sheridan Road. Motion by Alderman Kirkwood. Second by Alderman Turner.
If you'd like me to, I'd be happy to, Alderman. The sale of this property was considered by the last city council several months ago. This is brought back to you at this time because of the change in the configuration of the council, because several of the members were in positions that were related to GWTC. And as such, there's some questions whether or not there was a conflicted issue that presented itself. But the motion to sell the property was passed, but not with an adequate cushion. The statute requires that in order to sell property, it has to have a vote of three quarters of the city alderman and of the entire city council, including the mayor, so that would take eight votes. This resulted in six out of nine that particular night. As such, it didn't have an adequate majority pass, so it's brought for you again today. Mr. Hughes has indicated he wishes to proceed with the purchase of property. Since Noel isn't here, I'll simply add that, you know, that this is a, normally I turn it over to her, but it's a piece that's out of ravine. That's where the old cap building used to be many years ago. And it hasn't been used, it's been vacant for a very long time since that building was torn down close to 20 years ago, not 20 years at this point. It's difficult to see how it could be built into much of anything since it is a very small parcel that is primarily vertical with bluff on it, leading down into the ravine. See if anybody else has any other questions.
Is there any more questions on this issue? Roll call, please.
Alderman Seager.
Aye.
Alderman Kirkwood.
Aye.
Alderman Turner.
Aye.
Item two. Requesting liquor license, OB Sweet Tea, 2929 North Tennessee Street, Waukegan, Illinois. Motion by Alderman Kirkwood. Second by Alderman Turner. Any questions on this motion?
They are here to present.
These are just a presentation this evening, is that correct, Madam Clerk?
That's correct.
Okay, so there won't need to be a motion. We'll just have a presentation here from the three applicants.
Okay.
Good evening, Councilman Waukegan. I thank you for this opportunity to present my request for a two liquor license of the city of Waukegan and 2929 to see where I operate, who we speak to, cafe, or not. I make this request.
Can we have your name for the record, please?
Oh, Sean White, I'm sorry, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Raise the mic up just a little bit. There you go.
All right, can you hear me now?
That's much better.
I make this request with great thought, as being in business over a year now, I'm losing out on customers who make that long walk from the Genesee Theater back and forth, where people come in to the cafe to eat, because I don't offer liquor, they ask me, do I have anything to drink as far as liquor, or any kind of alcoholic beverages, and respectfully, I say no, at this time, I don't have a liquor license. And I thought I would probably make it without having a liquor license, but as I pull my consumers who walk by on the street, or they come in, they say, hey, it'd be great with this jerk chicken that I sell there, that they have something to drink with that, also besides pop and sweet tea and lemonade. And I also ask for a brew license, because I also make my own gourmet lemonade and sweet tea, and people always say, can you mix that with a summer shandy? So after great thought and great time, I've experimented, I was able to make one, where I can mix lemonade and sweet tea with the beer to make a nice summer shandy for those people who like to come in. I think that'd be also another draw to see Waukegan, and we also, I know that we have another microbrewery or group up that's coming, but also have another one that has something coming unique and different, where you're mixing beer with sweet tea and lemonade to come up with my own version of that. So the request I'm making is just because I'm losing out on potential dollars that walk by me every day. Not that it's just gonna sell my business, but it'll just add to the more entertaining value of downtown Genesee. And as the Genesee Theater grows, and as I count the people that walk by, and they ask me what's on the menu, and I show them the menu, but they want something else to go with it besides pop, tea, and lemonade. And I think what I would want to offer is just a can service, and bottle service, where that would just serve bottles and cans, and nothing really being poured, just for the microbrewery part of having the sweet tea and lemonade is prepared, but not more than full pour license, but you can also serve it from coolers, so I can get beer, cans, and bottles, and also wine, that's the size of the product you see in Waukegan Cove. But I do appreciate the time to speak, but I do believe, since I've been in business for over a year, I've been really want to stay in business, and I think it's been a way to just give another asset, another revenue stream to my business. I'm open to entertaining questions from the council or the board if that's possible, sir.
Can we clarify that that is just a beer and wine license you're asking for?
The A2, that's what's also the brew license also. The
brew license, which is beer, wine, and craft beer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No hard liquor. That's why we were trying to figure out this morning how you can make sweet tea hard without liquor, but
I researched it,
if you can do it.
It's a summer, like a summer shandy. I know that you probably had one. You have one. Wine Pools does it. So I'm not saying I'm taking the recipe, but I've experimented with it. I think that the people I've given it to, they enjoy it.
So this is your own recipe?
Yes, sir. I look forward to when you give me the license to come down and sample it.
Good.
Any more questions?
Okay. Any questions?
Once again, I thank you for your time.
Thank you, Walter.
Requesting liquor license, Wendland Restaurant and Bar Incorporated, 30 North Genesee Street, Waukegan, Illinois, 6085. Is anybody here? Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Steve Forrest with
Wendland. Please state your name.
I'm Steve Forrest with Wendland Investment Group. This is
Armando Mendez with the owner of the Wendland Restaurant Bar.
Yeah. We humbly come before you tonight to request a liquor license for 30 North Genesee. We are opening a Wendland Restaurant and Bar. This is planned to be a full-service restaurant. We intend to serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Our target clientele is the working population, primarily up here in downtown city of Waukegan. We request this license because obviously we'd like to serve libations in the evening hours, as also even sometimes brunch, champagne, or maybe even Bloody Mary, too. But we plan to have service hours from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m., Monday through Friday, and brunch on Sundays with possible open on Saturdays as well.
I've got a question. What was there prior to you, like, playing with that club?
Some whiskey, Waukegan whiskey joint.
Waukegan whiskey.
Big Ed's.
Big Ed's.
Who's with Big Ed's?
Was Big Ed's. Okay, thank you.
Thanks.
And D, present liquor license, Great Lakes Burger. 1508 Washington Street, Waukegan, Illinois, 6085. Present.
Hello, my name's Aaron Sherman.
Secretary, yes.
And we are the owners of GLBB LLC. We are requesting liquor license for the building at 1508 Washington Street. It's formerly Smalls, maybe Smalls. Now it's currently unoccupied, and so we're requesting liquor license owner for full service restaurant. And also our focus on burgers and a little bit of a higher end. That we feel is underserved in the community. And at normal business hours, brunch on Saturday and Sunday. And we plan on reducing the footprint of the bar that currently is there and making it more of a restaurant atmosphere than just a bar.
Mr. Sherman, I can't picture where that is. Is that close to Lewis?
That is one block west of Butler.
West?
On the north side, it's on the north side of the street.
Yeah.
A little west of where Ophelia's or Palooka's was.
So currently Victor and I both have businesses in Waukegan. Booner's Place on Washington Street, and Victor owns Taqueria Toluca on 10th Street.
So this is the old Edison Square?
I believe it was before it was Smalls.
Yeah. Thank you.
It's across from Artistic Cleaners. It's not the Edison Square. Artistic Cleaners, the Red Cross, Artistic Cleaners.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. No reports, communication? Motion to adjourn. Motion to adjourn by Alderman Kirkwood, second by Alderman Turner. 5:25. All those in favor?
Aye.